From beautiful Baja Tusta, the headquarters of the McNeil International Film Studios, we get to talk today about price output determination for pure competition using the graphs. Now you recall that a firm in pure competition has three characteristics. Many small firms, each firm is so small relative to the market that they are price takers. Once the price is determined in the market, the firm has no pricing power, no choice but to accept the price that the market gives them. And they can sell all they're capable of producing at that price. So, once the market has decided that the price is P1, then, let's say this price is $10, then this becomes the demand curve to each firm in this industry. It's also the marginal revenue curve, and it's price. So that's the first characteristic. Each firm in a purely competitive market or industry is a price taker. The second is there is free entry and exit of firms, and the third is the product is homogeneous. Each firm makes a perfect substitute for every other firm. Excuse me, would you please put your phone away? Put it away.
But it's a new one.
Yeah, put it away. I snap. I might break it. All right. Now, if the price is $10, the question is, if these are a firm's, the typical firm in this industry, we'll say, if this is the firm's cost curves, then this is marginal revenue, that's marginal cost, and you produce the quantity where marginal cost equals marginal revenue. And it's the logic that matters most. What this point on the, where is it? This is marginal cost right here, marginal cost. If they produce the first unit, this point on the marginal cost curve says the marginal cost of this first unit is something like $2. But if we look at the marginal benefit, that's the marginal revenue, this firm's going to get $10 if they produce and sell it. That means that it will add $8 to their profit. The next unit, that's the marginal cost, that's the marginal benefit. If they produce it, they'll add that much to their profit, etc. So they will produce all of the ones for which the marginal benefit exceeds the marginal cost. All of these add more to the benefit than they do to cost until you get right there. That's where marginal revenue equals marginal cost. And that's the quantity they would want to produce, 22 units. And the reason they wouldn't produce the next unit is because the marginal cost would be greater on the next unit than the marginal benefit, and their total profit would decrease, would be smaller by that amount. So they've maximized where marginal revenue equals marginal cost. In this case, it's 22 units. Now, when they produce 22 units, you go back up. Come up here. This point on the average variable cost curve says that if they produce 22 units, $6 is the average variable cost of producing each of these 22 units. Keep going. This point is on the average cost curve, and it says $8 is the average cost of producing each of these 22 units. And the difference between these two is the average fixed cost, because we know that average fixed cost plus average variable cost equals average total cost. Now, if the average total cost is $8 and the price they're getting for each of these is $10, then that means they're making $2 profit on each of the 22 units. So, when we ask what quantity should this firm produce in order to maximize its profits or minimize its losses, the answer is produce the quantity where marginal revenue equals marginal cost, and in this case it's 22 units. The next question is what price, and the price comes from the market. This firm is a price taker, has no choice about that. The third question then would be what will be profit per unit? And profit per unit has a formula, price minus average cost. So in this case, the price is 10. The average cost, on average, each of these is costing $8, which means the profit per unit is $2 per unit. And what will be the total profit? T pi symbol for profit. That is equal to profit per unit times quantity produced. So in this case, they're making $2 on each unit, and they're producing $2 on each unit, and they're producing 22 units, which means the total profit will be $44. And this area right here, the total area here is 2 times 22, which represents total profit. Let's make this red. This entire rectangle here is equal to, that one, is equal to price times quantity, which we all know to be total revenue. So the red rectangle is total revenue. The green rectangle, let's make it green here. This green rectangle, right there, can you see it? That green rectangle is average cost times quantity, which means it's total cost. And total cost is broken down into two areas. Total variable cost, that's total variable cost, that lower rectangle, and this is total fixed cost because the two of them together add to total cost. So that's what quantity, what price, what profit per unit, what total profit, and then the rectangles of total revenue, total cost, total profit, and we break the total cost down into total fixed and total variable. Now, there are two more bits to deal with here. The first is, if this is the firm's average cost curve, that's the average variable cost, and that's marginal cost. These are dollars, and this is quantity produced. This is the market, and this is a firm's cost. So we go over here to the market, there's supply, there's demand, and this is the price. We'll call it P2. Now, what if the price in this market is right there? Right there. What if that's P2? This is a price where, this is price, and it's also marginal revenue to the price taker. But, and so they would produce exactly where marginal cost equals marginal revenue, that quantity. That's the quantity they would produce. And as they go back up, dinkity, dinkity, dink, there is the average variable cost from the average variable cost curve. And then we keep going up. And this point is shared by marginal cost, marginal revenue, and average cost. So the average cost is exactly equal to the price in this case. And so you will recall, first of all, that's the quantity, that's the price, but you will recall that profit per unit equals price minus average cost. Well, if the price is $9 and the average cost is $9, the profit on each unit is zero, and total profit will be zero also. So right here, where this point of the minimum average cost, if the price is that price, then the profit will be zero. Now, the next question, of course, is what if the price is lower than that? What if the price is lower than the minimum point of the average cost? That means that if the, let me draw it on another page here. That means if the market price is, we'll say, P3 here, and this is the firm's average cost, average variable cost, and there's marginal cost. What if this price is P3 right here? Well, this is the marginal revenue and price, and it's the firm's demand curve. But look, they will produce where marginal revenue equals marginal cost. That's the quantity, call it Q3. But as we go back up, sure enough, it's a price that is sufficient to cover all of the average variable cost, but not all of the average cost. This means all of the variable costs are covered and some of the fixed costs, but they're going to lose some of their fixed costs. So this means that in this case, since the average cost of producing each of these, say it's $9, when the price is only $7, it means they're going to lose $2 on each unit. And so this gap between the average cost and the price is reversed. It means there's a loss. Will the firm produce at a loss? And the answer is yes, provided that the price is sufficient to cover all of their variable costs. If the price will cover all of their variable costs, then they're better off to produce than to shut down, because if they shut down, they lose all of their fixed costs. That is the gap between the average cost and average variable cost. They would lose all of that amount. But if they produce, they just lose some part of their fixed cost. So they're better off to produce than to shut down. What if the price is exactly equal to... What if the price is exactly equal to... Right there. Average variable cost. Well, that would be the price equals marginal revenue equals demand. And they would produce where marginal cost equals marginal revenue. That would be Q4, we'll say. But it's just enough to cover their variable costs and none of their fixed costs. Their average cost is this much. And all of this gap between average variable and average total cost is their average fixed cost. So at this price, P4 we'll call it, if the price coming out of the market is P4, the firm, if it produces, will just cover its variable costs and none of its fixed costs. So it will lose all of its fixed costs if it produces. But what if it shuts down? It will lose all of its fixed costs. All of its fixed costs. So at price P4, the firm is indifferent about producing. If it produces, it loses its fixed costs. If it shuts down, it loses its fixed costs. So now, what if the price is below that? At any price below this minimum point of the average variable cost, will the firm produce? Will the firm produce? No. It will shut down. Because at any price below that, they would not only lose all of their fixed costs, but then the price isn't enough to cover their variable costs either. So they would lose more than their fixed costs if they produce. They're better off just to shut down and lose their fixed costs. So that leaves us with our final little picture here. Trust me, this is fine. So if with a price taker, these are the price taker's cost curves. There's average cost, average variable cost, and marginal cost. Right here, this at this price, we'll call it PLR because that's the long run price. That's the price, that's the point of minimum average cost. If the price coming out of the market here, this is the market, is exactly that, then the firm would produce that quantity. And since the price is exactly equal to average cost, zero profit. We'll call it I for indifferent. If this is the price coming out of the market, the firm is indifferent about producing it. At any price above PLR here, this is a price above the average cost, and so the firm will produce and earn a profit. At any price below average variable cost, this minimum point of average variable cost, the firm will shut down. It will produce zero quantity, and it will just lose its fixed costs. So that leaves this last little zone here. What about any of these prices? If the price is anywhere in the between the average cost and the average variable cost here, then the firm will produce at a loss because it'll lose less by producing than by shutting down. I think that is decision making to a price taker firm in the short run. I give you a set of costs, and I tell you every possible price and what the firm will do. So that's what this is about.